Hello, everyone, and welcome to my Team of the Weekend show on Flatcap Euro Talk, the show where I pick the top performers from this last weekend across Europe's top five leagues. I do try my best to stay neutral in these picks, but I do hope you give me any players that you may think have actually I probably snuffed out in the comments down below. But without further ado, everybody, let's crack into this one. It's going to be a very interesting 11 that I've chosen for today. I've gone for 4-2-4 in this case. You know, I have to always pick a lineup, right, that still could kind of make sense. You know, got to still respect the goalkeepers and defenders and whatnot. We're not only just picking attackers. We're trying to make a real 11 to the best of our ability here. So we are going to start off in goal with Rafael Gikiewicz. The former Union Berlin man who had a clean sheet versus Borussia Mönchengladbach. I believe he's a Polish keeper, Rafael Gikiewicz. He's, you know, has his days. You know, had some good performances in the past for Union Berlin, but now plays for Augsburg, and they just had a 1-0 victory over Borussia Mönchengladbach. So I figured I'd give the man a bit of respect for that. Absolutely fantastic performance for Augsburg. That's a great 3 points for them. They definitely are very proud of themselves in southern Germany. Going on to my two fullbacks of the weekend, it is going to be Rafael Guerrero and Denzel Dumfries. I swear Rafael Guerrero might just win it every week. I always love this guy. He just scores absolute bangers. He just did again here for Dortmund, where he kind of received it on the half volley by surprise, kind of hit it off his chest, and then just on the half volley just smashed it with his left peg. It was kind of inside the box, but still pretty far away, probably an 18-20 yard strike maybe, if I'm not mistaken, and just hits it into the top corner across the goalkeeper to open up the scoring for Dortmund in their 4-2 win over Union Berlin. Rafael Guerrero, just absolute baller. I'm pretty sure everybody knows of him by now, though. And Denzel Dumfries is going to be my other fullback, who had two assists, I believe, in Inter's 6-1 rout over Bologna. Denzel Dumfries, the reason he's being selected here is because he's on fantastic form for Filippo Inzaghi's side at Inter. I think he's fantastic signing for them if they're going to be doing that 3-in-the-back, 5-in-the-back system. He's absolutely rapid. He's also very good at getting forward at the right moments. He's so dangerous and so good at also tracking back as well. Very powerful, very industrious, very intelligent, just an all-around amazing fullback or wingback in a back 3-back-5 system. My center halves for the weekend are going to be Jan Bednarek and Christopher Ayer, Jan Bednarek, you know, just had that 0-0 clean sheet over Man City. Definitely got to give the man some respect. I also feel like he, if I'm not mistaken, he did just sign a new contract as well until 2025 for Southampton as well. So that definitely must be included. I think Jan Bednarek, you know, he's just a quality, you know, Premier League defender. And, you know, having a 0-0 clean sheet over Man City is a fantastic point for them. So definitely got to give the man his due consideration for that. And then Christopher Ayer, the new signing from Celtic for Brentford, he just had a clean sheet as well in their 2-0 win over Wolves. So definitely got to have two Premier League defenders there with two very impressive clean sheets for either of them, for both of them there. My midfield is just going to be a midfield two of Danilo Cataldi and Joshua Kimmich. With Danilo Cataldi, this man just had an absolute screamer to equalize with Cagliari. A very, very exciting game, I will say, for Lazio, despite them not really being probably happy with that result and only grabbing a point. It still was a fantastic equalizing screamer. I think it was in the 83rd minute for Lazio. Really got to check it out. Just absolute top end, side foots it. Really incredible goal. And then Joshua Kimmich had a brace, I do believe, for Bayern and against VfL Bochum. Pretty huge rout of that team, 7-0 in Bavaria, you know, at the Allianz Arena during the Oktoberfest season. I mean, there's only one team that's going to come out of that, and still a 7-0 rout, though. Maybe Julian Nagelsmann's side is starting to settle down a bit, potentially, but they definitely have had some shaky moments to begin, so it's good to see Joshua have a brace here. My front four of the weekend is going to be João Pedro, Edin Dzeko, Erling Braut Haaland, and Davide Faraone. João Pedro had a fantastic goal and assist against Lazio. His first goal was this beautiful dink header over the top of the keeper for Lazio. And then as well, might have been Pepe Reina, I think he dinked over. And then as well, he had a very nice assist that was very composed to Keita Balde, the former Lazio man as well, who scored against his former club So definitely a fantastic performance for Joao Pedro, well led by him, you know, the veteran player. Edin Dzeko had a fantastic brace as well in that huge rout that they had over Bologna. He had one of his finishes included this absolute roof of a finish. He took it down the byline and then just curled it into the top of the roof. I mean, practically, you know, just made the keeper, you know, think about his career, you know, the way that he finished it over him. Just an unbelievable finish from Edin Dzeko. And we're quite used to that, but I really have to check out that finish. Very, very clever and just very clinical. Just shows his technical ability when it comes to finishing. And then Erling Braut Haaland had a fantastic brace as per usual. I think that's 10 goals and 7, I believe, or 11 goals and 7. For his country and club at the moment this season to begin with. So, I mean, as per usual, Erling is just absolutely starting off on fire. One of his goals was an insane dink over the keeper where he was muscling off his defender, the Union Berlin defender, and then somehow found the intelligence and the time to be able to still dink it over the keeper in a pretty spectacular fashion. So definitely have to check out Erling Braut Haaland's goal. Just an unbelievable, beautiful goal. And then the last one here, and not least, is going to be Davide Federoni. And Davide Federoni had an absolute screamer to go ahead over Roma in Hellas Verona's 3-2 win over Roma. Jose was a bit sad, definitely, after this one, especially considering this goal. I mean, Davide Federoni, I mean, absolutely tip your cap. An unbelievable hit. I think he's a right mid / right back, wing back. For Hellas Verona, but definitely I would say, you know, these are the moments that you have to include players like this, because it really was an incredible goal that he scored to have their win over Roma, and a slight upset for sure for Hellas Verona. So very, very good goal by Davide. But that, everybody, thank you. This is going to be my 11. Do thank you for, you know, listening to my picks here. The purple ones that are highlighted in purple for these players are the ones that I do think maybe are the most ones that you should be considered the most, I would say, in each position. So for, you know, the defense, it's Denzel Dumfries. I just feel like you got to keep an eye on him. He's in fantastic form this season and a fantastic signing by Inter. And then as well, Joao Pedro, I would say in terms of the attack, is one that I would definitely consider with that. Apologies for the typo and misspelling. For that fantastic goal and assist they had over Lazio. And then for the midfield, it would be Davide Federoni with that absolute screamer versus Roma to go ahead for Hellas Verona. So a pretty decent weekend, I would say, especially in the Serie A. Some very, very good goals in the Serie A. I would definitely check out a lot of the highlight packages over there. But like I said earlier, that'll be all for now, everybody. Please do let me know if there are any selections that you feel like I snubbed out on or any ones I'm missing for this one. But do, again, please let me know in the comments for that, because I do like to know which players or maybe which highlights I might have missed this weekend. But do, thanks for tuning in. Please subscribe if you're new. Smash that bell to never miss another video like this one. Please, please hit that shiny red button down below as well, so you can stay tuned with everything here on Flatcap Euro Talk. And I'll be seeing you.